Hi everyone, my name is Mike and I'm a student at the University of Rochester. When I came to the US, the biggest problem I faced was the allocation of time. I'm double majoring, I was a member of multiple clubs and I've been on multiple club e-boards. I've traveled domestically and internationally. And the biggest question I always had is how can I take more out of the time I have? If you stick towards the end of the video, I'll tell you the secret that I found to having a successful and enjoyable college life. I hope you enjoy. First, let's talk about the problem. Let's be honest, being a college student is quite overwhelming. There's so much you need to do. Starting from academics, you might have one or multiple majors, continuing with extracurricular activities, continuing with finding jobs, internship, and life after college, continuing with staying physically active and connected with your friends, and so on and so forth. There's a lot to do. And many students fall into negative health-affecting habits like cutting on their sleep hours, ruining their diet, cutting on exercise, and so on and so forth to save those hours and reallocate them. I'm fully against those solutions. Let me give you three tips on how to have a better college experience and allocate your time better. Tip number one, do something called zero-based budgeting. It's a concept that comes from accounting and means that at the end of every quarter, the company reevaluates how it spends its money. The alternative to it is to just go with the flow and keep spending money till somebody decides to close a certain project or open a new one. In terms of your personal life and my personal experience, it helps a lot. What I do for myself is at every beginning of the semester, I take some time and go through all the activities that I do. Whether it's academics, clubs, extracurricular activities, hanging out with certain groups of friends, do exercising, going to the gym, going to the swimming pool, whatever it is. I write it all out and I evaluate whether it's still worth my time. Because perhaps the club that I really enjoyed back as a first year doesn't really cut it for me anymore as a sophomore. So why should I keep it? And this act of setting aside time once every semester and thinking about you reallocating your whole 24 hours in the day is very powerful and helped me a lot. And I wish it could help you too with both applications to American colleges and studying here. Tip number two, try to have an activity against which you can benchmark everything else you do. Let me explain. For me, this activity is working on my startup with friends. It means that whatever else I do could either be more effective, efficient, and beneficial for me in the long run than this activity, or less beneficial, efficient, effective, whatever, in the long or short run than this activity. Hence, whatever I want to do something, or whatever I think about, you know, picking up a new hobby, picking up a new club, picking up a new commitment, I ask myself, hey, is it better or worse than my work on a startup? If the answer is yes, it's more efficient, then I pick it up. If the answer is no, and it's less efficient, less effective for my future goals, then why should I bother? I can just spend more time on the startup. Tip number three. So far, we've talked about time management, but the tip number three is all about energy management. It means managing the activities throughout your day so that activities that drain energy from you are efficiently combined with activities that give energy to you so that overall, you're more productive and more efficient at achieving what you want to do every single day. To learn more about that, just simply Google energy management, and there are a lot of videos out there talking about students and their tips. Thank you so much for watching till the end. I hope you like the videos. If you do, please like and subscribe. And let me give you one more tip that was the most impactful for me. I was once told that life is just today repeated, which makes total sense because life is just a series of todays over and over again, which means that the small changes you make today to your life, to your schedule, to your energy management, to how you spend your time are so powerful because they will propagate over every single day of your life, which means that you, yes, you watching this video and waiting to do something or really procrastinating on that one thing, you can start doing it today and change your whole life. I hope you take it away, and I see you next time.